to Urgent Jazz, and today I'm going to be discussing three new albums, and each album is led by a female instrumentalist. And that's where the similarity ends. Each album is played in quite a different style of jazz music, a different genre, and not only that, each woman plays a different instrument. So let's start with the first album by the bassist Linda O, and the album is called Initial Here. It's a very fun album from beginning to end. Linda O plays both the electric bass and the double bass. I would say there's probably more double bass work than electric, but she's extremely proficient in each. Compositions are extremely varied and extremely contemporary. And as I said at the beginning, it's a very fun album. Like everything she does, you feel like it has the intention of enjoyment and good times. I also said it's very varied. There's funky music, there are deep grooves, and there's more standard style jazz songs at play. The band is composed of Dana Stevens on tenor sax, maybe another woman. Fabian Almazan on piano, Rhodes, and melodica. And lastly, Rudy Royston on drums. So this is a great album. I've listened the hell out of it over the last year, and I don't think anybody would be disappointed. It's a good time. Next album is by guitarist Mary Halvorson, and it's by her quintet, and the album is entitled Bending Bridges. Compositions definitely have a more intentional groove and approach, which is perpetuated throughout the whole album. And I would say this groove is more avant-garde, more abstract. The melodies are very creative. And what's interesting is within this more avant-garde and new approach to playing and compositions, the musicians actually interact extremely well and are all playing very fascinating lines with each other. Speaking of the band, they are Jonathan Finlayson on trumpet, John Irabagon on alto saxophone, John Hébert on bass, and Chess Smith on drum. Halvorson, with her compositions and her playing, is really trying to take jazz in a novel direction, something I haven't heard before, but something I really enjoy. So, another great album from 2012, I highly recommend it. Thank you. The next album I'm going to be talking about is by Anat Cohen, and it's entitled Clarinet Work Live at the Village Vanguard. Anat Cohen is a clarinet player, and her band is composed of Benny Green on piano, Peter Washington on bass, and Lewis Nash on drums. Actually, what attracted me to this album initially was her backing band, because I love all these guys, and I've been following Benny Green since he was playing with Ray Brown in the 90s. But I was very happy to discover Anat Cohen playing with this Benny Green trio style band. Of a standard approach to jazz, bop jazz, and it's got a lot of bluesy elements to it, but the live angle to it really infuses the album with a sense of passion, a sense of urgency, and a sense of groove, a deep, deep groove. Benny Green is always great. There's a couple of awesome bass solos by Peter Washington, and Lewis Nash is one of my favorite drummers. Anat Cohen kills it throughout. The album is more or less dedicated to Benny Goodman, but she plays in a very contemporary style, even though Benny Goodman was playing at a much earlier date in the 40s and 50s. So I would say out of the three albums I've talked about, I actually like this Anat Cohen the most, but I often favor live recordings, so that's not surprising. Are these three records led by female musicians, but they're all three excellent examples of contemporary young musicians playing today. So forget the fact that they're all female band leaders and just pick up these three albums as excellent examples of modern contemporary jazz music.